Now, how do I create power so that I can give it to everybody? Now, today, weekend, Saturday, Sunday, if someone behaves the wrong way, remember, I am the giver. If someone has done anything wrong to you in the past, behaved wrongly in the past, can I forgive? Can I forgive? How many have somebody on the list whom we have not forgiven? अच्छा नहीं हाथ उठाओ but ऐसा नहीं हो सकता है जी अच्छा ओ नहीं forgiveness मतलब किसी की बात बुरी लगी पकड़ के रखिए उस दिन उसने ऐसा किया even if it's a little ones not the major big ones but little ones even a simple thing हम उनके घर गए उन्होंने पूछा ही नहीं ठीक से उन्होंने बात की ही नहीं उसने मेरे बारे में ऐसा बोला All these very, 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 very small things. But these small, small things are reducing this power. Big things in life happen very rarely. Small things happen every single day. So soul power doesn't get depleted in big things because big things is once in a while. Many of your lives, no big thing would have happened. Life is going smooth. But small, small situations are happening every single day. So can I forgive people? Can I forgive people? Yes? Can I forgive people? Yes, because who am I? Anyways, they didn't hurt me that day. Who created the hurt? Who hurts me? Don't they hurt me, they hurt me, they hurt me. Don't live like this. Master, nobody can hurt me. Only one person can hurt me. Only one person can hurt me. Who? Myself. And who can heal me? Myself. Don't stand in front of people like this. Sorry, bolo. Apologize bhi nahin kiya. Thank you bhi nahin bola. Sorry bhi nahin bola. This is over today. Those who are givers should never be like this. Whether it's physical, whether it's emotional. Giving is giving and asking is asking. And we've realized asking is not happiness. Only what is happiness? Giving. So forgiveness is normal, natural, immediately. Immediately. It doesn't create any pain. In 1 second, it's over. Conserve power. It is this soul power which is impacting health of body. So if nothing else, do it to save your body. Do it to save your heart. Stop holding on to things like this. ऐसे ऐसे इतना पकड़ के रखेंगे दर्द इधर होता है बाद में सो वी आर द मास्टर्स ऑफ आवर लाइफ सो वी आर शिफ्टिंग टुडे फ्रॉम टू गिविंग वन इन विद द प्लैनेट टू विद पीपल राइट डू वी वांट एनीथिंग फ्रॉम पीपल नाउ कुछ चाहिए लोगों से पक्का क्या चाहिए बताइए क्या चाहिए कुछ नहीं चाहिए वेरी गुड रिमाइंड योर सेल्फ एवरी सिंगल डे कि मुझे कुछ नहीं चाहिए आई एम कंप्लीट एंड द पर्पज ऑफ माई लाइफ इज टू द पर्पज ऑफ माई लाइफ इज टू गिव एंड द पर्पज ऑफ माई लाइफ वेन इट इज टू गिव देन द मोर आई गिव द मोर आई एनर्जाइज Even physically, when you do projects like that you give, initially it looks like, where will the money come from? Where will the funds come from? How long will this project sustain? But it's a fact that anybody who did save us selflessly was never short of money. Right or wrong? Why? Because when you do save us selflessly, you've earned blessings and blessings will bring all the resources. Even if there is a period where you feel, no, we are short on money or we are short on resources, just remain stable and have faith. Faith that this is niswarth seva. Hamare paas aaj paise nahi honge, lekin duaye hamare paas bharpur hain. And duaye asambhav ko sambhav karte hain. Blessings make the impossible possible. Rest? Yes or no? It makes the impossible possible. We thought money makes impossible possible. We thought connections make impossible possible. We thought networking is very important. You never know who I would need in life. And so we keep everybody's visiting cards. Problem aayegi to kisko phone karna hai. There is only one thing which can take care of us always, and that is our karma. Not people, not money, not resources. It is our karma. And so create karma of those which earn blessings. Duaen kamani hai sara din. Duaen kamani hai, and everything we do, even while parenting, it is seva. Seva is not just a project, seva is a sanskar. Seva is a consciousness. Always seva. What happens when we are on seva? Like suppose sometimes we go to a temple, we go to a gurdwara, we go to an ashram, we do seva. So what is the difference when we are on seva and when we are at home? Is there any difference? Is there any difference? No expectations, yes. Seva is humility. You go to a temple, you go to a gurdwara, you will see people cleaning the floors, cleaning the vessels, picking up people's chappals, doing everything. They will come in big cars, park their car outside, and then go to the shoe rack and pick everybody's chappals and keep there. They are there for seva. Come home. Come home. And then somebody says, chappal dena ek minute. Tumhare haathon ko kuch hua hai? Apni chappal uthao apne aap. अभी तो आप सबकी चप्पल उठा रहे थे, वो तो हम सेवा कर रहे थे. सेवा इज ह्यूमिलिटी, ओनरशिप इज ईगो. सो सेवा एवरीवेयर, सेवा ऑलवेज, बिकॉज ह्यूमिलिटी इंक्रीजेस सोल पावर, ईगो रिड्यूसेस सोल पावर. सो फ्रॉम टुडे आई एम अ सेवाधारी. पुट अ टैग, हु एम आई? Sevadhari, seva always. Giver means seva. Giver means seva. So seva at work, seva at home, seva in the world, seva for the planet. Even work is seva. It doesn't mean you're doing charity. You're earning, your business, lots. But the intention is you are doing seva for the world through your business. The intention is you are doing seva of the people who are working with you. Aisa nahi daant diya aur kaam kara liya. Sabse zyada duaen apni workplace pe earn karni hoti hain. Sabse zyada blessings have to be earned at our workplace. You know why? Because the money comes from there. And so the way we work is getting the vibration for the money. So if I just shout at somebody, get angry with somebody, push somebody down, pull somebody here, and I earn big money, but that money has come with pain. That money has come with pain, and everything in my house is bought with that money, whether it is food, whether it's education, whether it's all the comforts, but then that pain is attached to that money. So dhan, money, should come with blessings, never with pain. So even the workplace is a place of seva. Nourish everybody, nurture everybody, strengthen everybody, be nice to everybody, be kind to everybody, be humble with everybody. Not ego, I am big, I am this, I am superior, I am richer, I am this. This ego is only going to earn pain in return. It's only going to earn pain in return. So we are on seva everywhere. Frequency change. Not seva in a project, seva in life. Ready? Yes? Itna silence kyun gaya? Everything okay? Haan. Seva is happiness. Because seva is our nature. If we look at our ancestors, everybody has a name of a kul devi, kul devta at home. So when we are saying devi devtas are our ancestors, to devi devta means? Devi, devta means data, dene wala. So how are the photos of the devi devtas? Giving. We have become levtas. And now to we are chintas only, we're not even levtas, we're grabbing. That is why our halo has shifted from white to dark. So when you are a giver, your aura will shift to white. That is why Devi Devtas are shown hands giving and white aura, which means contentment, soul power full, because they are givers. And we are saying they are our ancestors. So which means, what is our nature? To give. To give. So we are on seva always. Done? So this weekend is homework. This is not theory that we are going to talk here. It has to be practical. Only to be able, like to do a project, you have to have money, and like to get that money, you have to earn that money. Similarly, to serve the world, to serve my family, to energize my family, because we are going through a time where every family needs at least one person who is increasing soul power on a daily basis. Which means you need one phone charged at home. Taki kaam aaye to ek ka to phone chalna chahiye na. Similarly, you need one person now who is working on building their soul power, which means you need one member in the family who is earning power. Few years back, we used to say, har ghar mein ek paisa kamane wala chahiye. If something happened to that person who earns the money, people used to say, ye ghar kaise chalega, kamane wala chala gaya. To ab bhi wohi samay hai, but ab dhan to bahut hai, अब शक्ति कमाने वाला हर घर में एक चाहिए, ताकि एनी सिचुएशन कम्स इन दैट हाउस, यू नीड वन पर्सन हु इज द पावर हाउस टू टेक केयर ऑफ दैट फैमिली. इफ एवरीबडी शेक्स, देन इट इज चैलेंजिंग. बट इफ देर इज इवन वन पर्सन हु इज वेरी स्ट्रांग, वेरी पावरफुल, दे विल एम्पावर एवरीबडी, दे विल स्टैंड स्ट्रांग इन दैट क्राइसिस. सो एम आई गोइंग टू बी द वन हु इज गोइंग टू अर्न द पावर फॉर द हाउस? यस, यस. For that, I need to create simple lifestyle changes. I need to start increasing soul power. We're doing a lot of things nowadays which are reducing soul power. What is it that we're doing to reduce soul power? One is emotional dependency. Second is our lifestyle. Get few basic principles right in your lifestyle. One is our sleep patterns. If I don't sleep right, I cannot be emotionally powerful. I am emotionally fatigued, mentally tired, just dragging throughout the day. And it doesn't mean sleep more, it means sleep deep, sleep at the right time. Don't say, kya karu, kaam itna hai, how can I sleep? Then I'm saying, I am a victim and I cannot earn power. I'm going to give my power away. So what is the best time to be asleep? What's the best time to be asleep? So 10 o'clock, lights of a house should be off. Andhera lagna chahiye. Ho sakta hai? Ho sakta hai? Ho sakta hai? Master of our minds, master of our life. Don't live like a victim and say, nahi, kya karo, ye, wo. We are creating our destiny. Tomorrow when this lifestyle takes a toll on our mind and body, can anybody undo it? No. The doctor will say, lifestyle. So why should we take it till there? Why not live healthy, live long and earn more money, rather than trying to earn everything very soon with the wrong lifestyle and then spending it on a lot of things which we didn't need to spend on? So kare early to bed. Bachpan mein sikha tha na, early to bed. Early to rise makes a person. Hum karenge tabhi koi chance hai ki wo bachchon par kuch asar padega. तो उनका तो पूरा ही चेंज हो गया. दे वॉन्ट टू स्टे अवेक द एंटायर नाइट. दे से वी कैन स्टडी बेटर इन द नाइट. दे हैव देयर ओन रूम्स नाउ, बट स्टिल दे फील दे कैन स्टडी बेटर इन द नाइट. वी हैड नो सेपरेट रूम्स, येट वी वर स्टडिंग इन द डे टाइम. सो इट्स जस्ट अ कल्चर, इज जस्ट अ हैबिट, नथिंग एल्स, एंड वी कैन गिव एनी एक्सक्यूज फॉर इट. सो वी कांट चेंज देम, वी कांट कीप नैगिंग देम. We can change ourselves and change the energy of the house. So by 10 o'clock, we are deep sleep. But for 10 o'clock deep sleep, we should have a light dinner, early dinner. heavy dinner does not allow deep sleep, because all our digestion is happening in the sleep. Second thing, we need to disconnect with all our business and work communication at least 2 hours before we go to sleep. Otherwise, only the body is sleeping, the mind is working in the night. Possible? Possible? आप बताओ, पॉसिबल तो है, नहीं तो कोई और बात करते. प्रायोरिटाइज योर लाइफ, प्रायोरिटाइज योर लाइफ. वर्क इज वन पार्ट ऑफ लाइफ, वर्क इज नॉट लाइफ. वर्क इज वन पार्ट ऑफ लाइफ एंड इट डज नॉट मीन दैट दोज हु डोंट वर्क एट नाइट विल वर्क लेस. दे विल वर्क मोर बिकॉज दे विल बी मोर एनर्जाइज्ड, एफिशिएंट, creative, intuitive, because they sleep deep sleep. But only way is they change their lifestyle to the healthy way. So if I keep working till night, phone, email, laptop, business conversations, then you go to sleep, mind is still working. And that's why when we wake up in the morning, we feel like sleeping a little more. Man karta na sone ka aur, because thaka hua man hai. फिर वो थके हुए मन को रोज ड्रैग करो, रोज ड्रैग करो, रोज ड्रैग करो. इट्स ओनली अ टायर्ड माइंड विच इज गेटिंग इरिटेबल एंड एजिटेटेड, नथिंग एल्स. टायर्ड माइंड. सो 8 o'clock तक डिस्कनेक्ट फ्रॉम वर्क, 9 o'clock तक डिस्कनेक्ट फ्रॉम ऑल अदर कॉन्टेंट. ऑल टीवी सीरियल्स बाय होम्स आर ब्रेकिंग, नीड्स टू बी स्विच्ड ऑफ. It's content, it's words, every single day in the house. Earlier it used to be once in a while. Now it's every day. World news, chaos. Now we say, news, I have to know what is happening in the world. To know what is happening in the world and to absorb completely the visual, the audio, the debate, the shouting, everything of what's happening in the world is a completely different picture. To know what is happening in the world, you just need 5 minutes to read one paragraph and you'll know what's happening in the world. But to watch all the trauma, the visual, the audio, the discussion, our mind doesn't have that much strength now. And we're doing that on a daily basis. And when are we doing it? On the 2 times which are most important for positivity, early morning and late night. Imagine watching the world news and going to sleep. It's like scaring your mind and go to sleep. The day we watch a horror movie, we can all make out, no, how our quality of sleep is. But we cannot make out on the daily basis, because daily basis our quality of what we are watching has changed. But the result is, we feel like sleeping a little more when we wake up, our creativity is less, and whenever we are sitting on a flight or a train not doing anything, we fall off to sleep. People on a flight nowadays can literally sleep through the entire flight. If they don't hold a phone and sit active. If we remove gadgets away from everybody's life, they will literally sleep through the entire flight. And that is a sign how sleep deprived they are. And ask them, you didn't sleep last night? Of course I slept last night. Why are you sleeping right now? How can anybody sleep in the daytime? Only that person can sleep who is sleep deprived. And most of us are sleep deprived. Why? Late night. Working till sleeping and watching all this content before sleeping and filling all that in the mind and then going to sleep. Kaise neend aayegi? Kaise neend aayegi? So sleep cycle is very integral in our emotional health, physical health, relationships, work, everything. You will not be able to be happy unless you experience deep sleep, because a tired mind gets irritated for everything. तो करके देखे डीप स्लीप, यस, एंड यू विल वर्क हार्डर एंड मोर, बट यू विल डू इट इन द मॉर्निंग, नॉट इन द नाइट. सो इफ आई स्लीप दिस वे एंड आई स्लीप बाय 10 AM, बिटवीन 4 and 5 AM अपने आप नींद खुल जाएगी. यू डोंट हैव टू पुट एन अलार्म, अपने आप नींद खुल जाएगी. दैट इज कॉल्ड द ब्रह्म मुहूर्त, द अमृत वेला. ब्रह्म मुहूर्त मीन्स द हाइएस्ट एनर्जी टाइम ऑफ द 24-hour साइकिल. And we are sleeping at that time. And children today are going to sleep at the muhurat time. I know it sounds funny, but see what it's going to lead to. If they are not going to sleep between the 10 to 3 band, their body is going to show a lot of result. This body has different organs which heal only at that specific time. And if I'm not asleep at that time, that organ of my body is going to get affected. So be very careful. But you can't tell them, you only have to do it first for yourself and they will do it. And so if you wake up at Amrit Vela, at Brahma Muhurat, your creativity, intuition power is highest. Now you do your work there, you'll finish in half an hour what you had to do in 2 hours in the night. And most important, throughout the day you're fresh, you're energetic, your tolerance power is higher, your power to adjust, your power to let go, your power to forgive, everything is higher because your mind is energized. And then when we wake up at Amrit Vela, Brahma Muhurat, what will we do? We start the day with meditation. Meditation means to charge this battery. I want to keep it charged throughout the day, but I need to charge it first, no, in the morning. So we all pray. But many times when we are praying, our mind goes here and there. Yes or no? Yes. And so in spite of praying, in spite of doing what we're doing, soul power is not increasing. Actually, all the prayers, all the rituals are made to increase our soul power. Because they are high energy words. They are a pure and powerful vibration. But because my mind is not there at that time, it goes here, there, there, everywhere and comes back. Soul power doesn't increase. So meditation is a technique to help us to increase our concentration, our focus, and to energize the self. So we need to take out a little time to learn that meditation. Are you ready to learn it? Are you ready to learn it? Yes. It's a necessity now. Now not an option. It's like a fitness. Like exercise, walk. It's nothing to do with religion. It's like an exercise for the soul and needed at the earliest stage possible. Gone that era that we will do it after 60, after 70. Now we need to do it 6 and 7, not 60, 70. And if the parents of a family are doing the meditation, automatically it starts influencing the children. They will come with you, they will sit around you, they will be in your vibrations, they will be in your aura, and very soon they will also start doing it. Even if they don't start doing it, they are getting influenced by your vibration. So it's a gift we have to give to them. So that we create a planet, we create a country where there's no depression, not that depression is normal. This is an epidemic actually. WHO has already said depression is the next pandemic. It is their line. Depression is the next pandemic. And is Bharat the country where we need to have all this? With yoga, with pranayama, with meditation, with spiritual principles, with community living, with seva bhav, with joint families. Is depression this where, this is the place where it needs to be? No. Bharat is a country which has lot of tools and techniques for emotional power. We are the country who can use them, empower ourselves and share that with the entire world. That is why the world is saying Bharat Vishwa Guru Banega. That is why the world is saying Bharat Vishwa Guru Banega. Because every country, every place will have their speciality, right? So when it comes to scientific principles, technology, we learnt a lot from other countries. But when it comes to spiritual principles, it is an ancient culture country. It is a country which is rich in that gyan and that wisdom. But the country will be able to share it with the world only and only if the people of the country use it themselves. Then we become an ambassador of health and happiness. Then become an ambassador of health and happiness. So every morning, begin the day with at least to begin with 15 minutes of meditation. And second thing that we need to integrate into our life is pure content everything every morning. Don't begin the morning looking at the phone. 5 minute ye, 5 minute wo, 5 minute wo. 10 minute mein sab kuch dekh liya. 10 minute mein everything gone over here. The blotting paper is full with everything that happened in the world. Early morning time is my time. If there's any emergency, people will call. Can we keep the phone away for the first hour of the morning? Can we keep the phone away for the first hour of the morning? Sure. Not 5 minutes dekhne ke baad 1 hour away. few days it will look difficult. After that it will become natural. Just imagine that you slept for 1 hour more. And when you wake up in the middle of the night, don't look at the phone. You won't be able to sleep after that. Mind will not sleep. It's a stimulant. This technology, which was designed to make our life comfortable, has made our life extremely comfortable. But the way we are using it is making our life unhealthy. The person who designed the phone never imagined that we would cling on to it like this for the rest of our life. They were just designing an object to make life comfortable. We got it like one in this pocket, one in this pocket, like this. Kuch bhi aur gum jaye utni tension nahi hoti. Kuch bhi. But phone idhar ka udhar ho jaye. So my deepest attachment is there, my dependency. So we need to do this de-addiction of technology. Otherwise, in the world it is already happening. In India, a few cities have already started, and that is called a de-addiction center for technology. And so that's the next thing. But if we do it, then we have the power to empower our children to be able to do it, not by saying it to them. So just experiment tomorrow morning. 1 hour, I see the phone 1 hour later. Don't say, agar koi emergency hui to, emergency hogi to koi message nahi karta hai. Will you message someone in an emergency? Nobody messages you also in an emergency. They will call. When they call, we pick up the phone. But if you go there, see the messages, see the social media, see the news, see the emails, everything. In 5 minutes, everything is here. And then my mind cannot create purity. It's already flooded with the world. So keep your first hour for yourself. Meditation, spiritual content consumption, physical exercise, whether it's yoga, pranayam, walk, exercise, whatever. But I give time for soul strengthening and body strengthening. And then you're out ready into the world with mind and body fit. Now you create magic in the world. Not going into the world with mind stressed, body ill, dragging ourselves throughout the day. Dragging ourselves. That's not the purpose of our life. The purpose of our life is to be a giver. To be a giver, I need to be earning that every day.